Greetings, I'm Solidus-Skully, and happy Australia Day! Don't know why I was getting very musical there, but yes indeedy, it is time for the finale of the Raid Trilogy that has been the Australia Day thing of this video series for the last couple of years at this point. Armor Games, and this also has the distinction of being the last Flash game I ever recorded before Flash games went the way of the dinosaur. Well, I mean, granted, I did record all three Raid games, at the same time before 2020, so it fits. And yeah, a bit of a misnomer here, because Raid Part 3 technically never got finished. So again, as the introduction is stating here, yes, this is technically Raid Part 3 introduction. Whether or not this is just meant to be a prologue game, you know, sealed so Ground Zeroes to the Phantom Pain or whatever else, yeah. I don't know whether this would have been included, but anyway. Yeah, to kind of go into that a little bit, Raid Part 3 never technically got a release. I mean, it was being worked on, but, well, for reasons... Actually, no, fuck it, I might as well state it now. Basically, because the creator pretty much bit off a bit more than he could chew, project just wound up being abandoned, and he just moved on with his life. Which, I mean, is a bit of a shame, because, I mean, as you're seeing right here, like, I mean, we got full-on... Well, I mean, we had full-on voice acting before, but, I mean, like, it's... It seems like the overall quality of everything is just massively improved from the animation to voice acting quality. Well, for the most part, and I don't know, everything just seems reasonably solid here.
Why not? You'll laugh.
So, yeah, the biggest problem with Raid Part 3 is that it isn't really technically a game. I mean, again, depending on what you could call gaminess, I mean, this game... I mean, the Raid series has technically been very pick-and-choose-your-own-adventure sort of thing. You only get one of those sort of decisions throughout the entire experience here. The rest of this is basically just context building for what would have been Raid Part 3. Although, again, a lot of this is primarily flashbacks and or, well, just character building. And in this case, it's basically showing us Ray's life before he entered the criminal underworld. He was a soldier. I believe this is meant to be during the Gulf War. And yeah, shows that he was a military man. With a rather ill-fitting voice, because Ray does actually speak in this game, unlike previous entries, and he...
Scouting ahead of him. I'm the N79.
Well, yeah, I mean, as you can listen right there, he sounds... The voice actor was probably in his teenage years, because he sounds quite, young for the sort of character that I think Ray was envisioned to be, as this sort of, like, you know, hard-ass sort of, you know, I'm really hard as fuck, bro! Sort of, you know, criminal dude. But I don't know, the voice isn't really solid, to be honest. Also, selective subtitles. I do apologize that you won't be hearing what a lot of these people are saying, but I wouldn't get a word in edgewise. But yeah, you're gonna be seeing an example of the animation really getting a boost here as you... Well, again, even throughout, you know, the very crude South Park sort of style, again, there's just a lot of good action scenes on display, and it does kind of make me sadden that Raid 3 never actually got a release, because, I mean, again, if the developer was capable of this, and goddamn, I love him for it. Although, it is also important to note, though, that a lot of these scenes were actually, well, again, as is examples of, a lot of, you know, Flash games of the time. Yes, copyrighted music be damned. I don't know if this is borrowed from anything, or maybe taken from a sound library or whatever, but you'll be hearing some examples of that a little bit later, because there's, one track specifically that's ripped right from the 2002 Resident Evil movie. But yeah, apart from, you know, giving us a bit of Ray's backstory, I'm not really too sure what this would have tied in. At least in terms of what the present-day plot would have been. I mean, I can speculate, but... Yeah, we're finally going to be getting back to Ray good and proper as we left him at the end of Part 2, when, Pete basically gave him the business and, well, had him shot.
Turn around, you fuck.
Action scene.
Get up.
Yeah, I guess maybe we're not at that scene yet.
Drop your fucking gun before
well.
Alright. Dumbass.
There we go. Alright, now we're back to the present. Oh no, he lost that creepy mustache. Good.
Now it's time to get out of this place.
Also, by the way, I don't know if this is an example of reusing character models, but wasn't that Ray's landlord? Oh, well, I mean, I suppose maybe he probably has a second job at the hospital, maybe he changed apartments since previously. Whatevers.
Fuck off. I'll be fine.
But anyway, after somehow miraculously surviving his gunshot wound of death, now Ray's pretty much just on the hunt to get revenge on Pete. Or so I presume.
I don't feel so good.
I mean, there is a little something that does kind of make me wonder why exactly... I don't know, really. I'll kind of get into that a little bit later when it's a little bit more... relevant, but... Yeah. It's quite odd, really, because, I mean, I don't really have too much to say about Ray Part 3, primarily because I really don't know where the plot was going or... what specifically was gonna happen. I mean, again, a lot of this is primarily just setup, and I mean... It's interesting to see, you know, what he was doing during the Gulf War, because again, as we see here, he's basically off on a mission to rescue one of his buddies.
Where would your friends most...
But I mean, apart from that, we don't really know what the significance is, why... You know, why a lot of it really matters, and how it ties into the present day.
Wrong answer.
And now I'm suddenly remembering scenes from, Fire Down Below. Oh no, wait, no, it was On Deadly Ground. You know, that Steven Seagal movie, where they broke a guy's leg, and we had Dr. Cox having "there's no I in team" speech.
You leave in 20 minutes.
Used to be you- Oh, here we go. Yep, this is where they borrow the music from the Resident Evil 2002 movie. Yes, Marco Beltrami and Marilyn Manson are no doubt pissed. I suppose I might as well spoil it right here, at least what I think was going to be happening. Again, as you're going to be seeing with a very similar looking character model, I'm guessing that the operative that the, you know, Ray and his buddy are going to be rescuing is either a relative of Pete's or somebody that he at least knew, so I don't know, I guess maybe that's why Pete gave him employment in the first two games. But, Pete betrayed him after Ray failed to get the drugs from the Colombians, and basically... I really have no idea what's going on. I mean, there is another thing that I also suspect might be a bit of a case as to why Ray does what he does, or... anything else, but I'm not too sure. Delicious. I don't know what that food was, but... now we'll never know. Man, it's a good thing nobody was really heavily guarding this place, although they're all on their fucking dinner break. Well, then again, my Gulf War history is a little bit, well, that was clumsy. Well, I mean, I guess it just shows that Ray isn't... Okay, never mind. It does. Even when he fucks up, he still succeeds. I'm curious, though. Like, I mean, would this have been playable in the full Ray Part 3, or would this have just been a prologue thing that wouldn't have been featured at all.
Where are they?
Anyway, this was what I was talking about earlier with the whole, relative to Pete thing. As we see inside here, he's being butchered, and he's cleaning his equipment. No doubt putting in the lake, you know, where the people will go swimming, and, you know, the executioner's tools will cause disease. Silent Hill 2 reference. Oh! Yeah, looks rather similar to Pete, and he lost a bit of his beard.
Just go.
So then they left. Because, fuck it, why not? Don't bring the body back for a proper burial or anything. Also, reusing the stock clip from Ray Part 2 when he was leaving in the helicopter. Sunsets over the beaches. Also, this is the same hobo dude in the first game that you could share the love with. By which I mean, give him some of your Jim Beam. Beam me up, Scotty.
What does it look like?
But again, like, I mean, there's a little bit more subplots at play rather than just, you know, Ray bumping about doing his thing. What you're gonna be seeing in a little bit, and I suppose I am kind of jumping the gun a little bit, but fuck it, I've only got 12 minutes of this shit. You also get to see Ray's personal life, by which of the fact that you learn that he actually has a wife and kid.
Excuse me, sir. Could you spare a couple of dollars?
Sure. For weed? Well, that was easy.
Wow, dude. Nice job.
Whatever. Now strip.
Yes, this is Ray's son, Leroy. And, basically, apart from just being your average kid who happens to like the Ninja Turtles, he's beaten up by these late 2000s-as-fuck-looking elementary school bullies. Or is he meant to be in high school? I really don't know. I guess they're meant to be preppy kids, because, again, in America they don't quite have school uniforms, so... fuck it, whatever. And here comes your one decision in the game. You can punch him, or just leave him alone. He takes after his father. Take no prisoners! Except he's still a kid and prone to getting beaten up, so, yeah, that doesn't really work out for him. And, by the way, if you decide to walk away, Leroy also still gets beaten up, and, here's Leroy's mom. Who, as we're gonna see soon, yeah, it's easy to see why Ray fell in love with her two big, juicy, glorious eyes. Yeah, but yeah, Ray pretty much pays a visit to his family home, then leaves to do his criminal endeavors, because apparently that would draw attention to his family, and, let's just say, Leroy's parents are not on very good speaking terms. By the way, it seems like a hell of a lot more time was spent modeling her as opposed to anybody else in the game, because she looks more anatomically human than your typical South Park character. Well, I say anatomically human, but I'm meaning in terms of, you know, the two big jugs over there.
Look, I just got out of the hospital, and I don't have time for your shit.
Again, I do really wonder exactly how a lot of this would have played out, because again, it does seem like it would have been an incredibly expansive game, because apparently there would have been like an hour of gameplay, you know, worth of, you know, making different choices, you know, different monetary systems. Again, it's kind of a shame, to be perfectly honest, that it never panned out to, you know, being a full game, but alas, we'll never know. And here's where we learn Ray's son's name. Early 2000 song, yeah. That's what I feel like doing right now. But yeah, now we pretty much have a montage. And again, I'm kind of curious, actually. Why did he get to keep the keepsake of the Gulf War? I suppose possibly the one connection Leroy has to his father. Would he have joined him in his criminal endeavors, or would he have just been kept out of the life? Who knows, but we'll never know, really. So, yeah, a bit of a rambly commentary, but not really too much to say about Ray Part 3 since it never truly happened. Anyway, on that note, I am Solidus-Skully, keep a new metal, and, happy Australia Day. Let's go get pished. Catch you next time.